In this video, I'd like to provide some tips on how to write a statement of purpose when you're looking to apply to a graduate program in health informatics. As a host of the Health Analytic Insights podcast, I've had the opportunity to review several statement of purposes, and I'm hoping to provide some general advice on how to structure your statement of purpose. So before even starting to write this statement of purpose, self-reflection is key. And this will really help you to organize your thoughts and hopefully help you with the flow of writing and help you to stick to that word limit if you really take the time to self-reflect prior to writing. So some questions you might ask yourself include, what is unique about the school you want to apply to? Do they have a professor whose research you are interested in? And if so, do they have any research papers which have piqued your interest? Does this college or university have specific courses that you feel will help jumpstart your career in the field of health informatics? And will the reputation of the school or their co-op or practicum program provide you with the necessary skills or experience to break into the field? So you can use the SMART goal planning method to really go through these questions, and SMART stands for specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. And use this acronym to really tailor your questions in the pre-planning stage prior to writing the statement of purpose. So once you've done that reflection step, including this reasoning in your statement of purpose is key, especially why you want to specifically apply to that particular program, because the admission planner will really want to know your reasoning behind this. When it comes to writing your statement of purpose, one tip is to make sure you're using the language of the institution you're applying to. So if you go on the website of the college or university that you're interested in applying to, many of them have visions or missions, and you might want to integrate this core mission into your statement of purpose. For instance, one university or college might state that the purpose of the certificate or degree program is to train students to use data to improve patient health outcomes. Therefore, you would want to include in your statement of purpose either research projects that you have done in the past or volunteer roles you hope to do in the future, which analyze or investigate trends in the data to improve health outcomes. So by adopting the language of the institution you're interested in applying to, this shows that you are aligned with the mission of the university and are a good culture fit. So as I said before, I've had the opportunity to review several statement of purposes, and what I've noticed is that people generally have profound stories on why they want to apply to the school, but what is often missing is how their future research will be beneficial to the school or how their career goals align with the school. And the key is to highlight that this is a symbiotic relationship. It's not just what the university can provide to you, but it's also about what you can provide to the institution. So if you have prior experience through research roles or projects from your undergraduate degree or from previous work experience, make sure to highlight this and how they fit into the future research you want to do and what positive impact this research will have for the institution. Another tip is to remember the statement of purpose is not a resume, and just simply listing your work or volunteer accomplishments won't be as impactful as telling a story about your career progression and how it relates to the field you're interested in learning more about. So you want to show and don't just tell. You might want to focus on one or two impactful projects or events and reflect on how they have guided you to apply to this specific program. So in my own statement of purpose, when I was applying for my master's in biomedical engineering, I highlighted my work at a children's rehabilitation hospital and how the work I did with analyzing swallowing signals to predict dysphagia, which a term for swallowing difficulties, drove me to want to apply to this program because of the research that was being done by professors at the school, specifically when it comes to predictive analytics and improving patient outcomes. So if you can think of one or two projects or research projects that you've done in the past and then connect it to either some of the courses that you might be doing in the future or some of the research projects you hope to do with advisors. This can really help to bolster your statement of purpose. And so just wrapping up, here's a general outline of a statement of purpose that you can follow when applying to a master's program. So paragraph one should be an introduction of your academic or professional background and what sparked your interest in the field of health informatics or a similarly relevant degree. Paragraph two can be about why should the admission panel select you for the program? So what makes you unique in comparison to other applicants? And this is where you can really do a deep dive into your experience and any past research that you've done. Paragraph three can be about how does your future research align with the mission of the school? Again, highlighting that symbiotic relationship of not just how the school will help you, but how you can help the school. Then paragraph four can go into potential research advisors you'd like to work with and how do your goals align with their research. It's important to highlight what you believe you will get out of the program. And by researching potential advisors and pointing to articles that you've researched, this shows that you have investigated the different research areas within the program or what specific courses you would like to apply to. And then the last paragraph can be a conclusion on what you will do once you have left the program with the knowledge and skills you have obtained. Potentially, what does your five-year career or academic plan look like, and how will the program help to jumpstart this? So finally, I'll just echo this. It's really, really important to have your statement of purpose reviewed by a variety of audiences, people who have experience in the health informatics field and people who do not. And make sure you follow all the rules regarding things like word count, the file format, and the file name that you should save it as. Don't let them have any reason to not look at your statement of purpose. And of course, it's important that your statement of purpose is grammatically correct and that it flows concisely and is impactful. So making sure that you get the statement of purpose reviewed by several people is key. So I hope those tips were helpful and best of luck with your application.